Hello friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. And in this video, I have a variety of questions to discuss with you. So I will not be wasting any time and beginning this video quickly. But the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. So here we have our first question. Recently, Gender Park has signed an MOU with UN Women to develop the Gender Park into a South Asia hub for gender-related activities. Which state does this gender park belong to? So basically, this gender park is an autonomous body under one of these states. So the right answer is Kerala. So basically, this gender park is an autonomous body under the state government of Kerala. And from the name itself, it is quite evident that the purpose of this gender park is to empower women and bring equality in the society. So now an MOU has been signed by this gender park with UN Women to transform this gender park into the South Asia hub for gender related activities. So basically all the gender related activities conducted by the UN and by this gender park in the South Asian region, in order to bolster that, this MOU has been signed by both these organizations. Now guys, where this gender park is exactly located? So it is located in the state capital of Kerala, that is Thiruvananthapuram. Now under this MOU, the UN Women will provide support to this gender park to conduct activities like research, development and activities to support women and to empower them. Apart from this, under this MOU only, India's first gender data center will also be established. So guys, where is this going to be established? Gender Data Center. So this is going to be established in Kozhikode. So basically, this gender park is located in Thiruvananthapuram and a branch of it is located in Kozhikode. And in that branch only, this India's first first gender data center is going to be established. So guys, there is another speciality of this Kozhikode campus. And that speciality is that there is an International Institute of Gender and Development located in this Kozhikode center of Gender Park. So I hope all the facts that I have told you here are clear to you, and in case you have any kind of doubt, feel free to ask me in the comment section or on the Telegram group that I have mentioned in the beginning of this video. So here all the facts related to this question are mentioned by me, so I am quickly moving on to the next question. But before that, I would like to hear from you that who is the head of UN Women, who is the person that is actually heading UN Women at present? So this is your question. From this question, I hope that you will mention your answers in the comment section below. So next question is again an MOU. So which state has signed an MOU with India Accelerator, India's only institution with global accelerator network, to boost the startup ecosystem in the state? Guys, the purpose of this MOU is quite clear, that is to boost the startup accelerators ecosystem in the state. Now, which state are we talking about? It is Haryana. So Haryana has signed this MOU with India Accelerator. Now, what is this India Accelerator? So India Accelerator is basically an organization that is the only institution at present with the global accelerator network, with connections with the global accelerator network. And with this India Accelerator, the Haryana government has partnered in order to boost the startup ecosystem of the state. Now guys, related to this India Accelerator, I want to share a fact. So the fact is that this India Accelerator is a seed stage accelerator organization. So basically, in the very infant stage of the startups, this India Accelerator provides support to the startups to become great. So basically to develop themselves. So that is the fact related to this India Accelerator. Now guys, this organization is an important one because it is India's first or the only organization we can say that has the global access to the Global Accelerator Network. So who is the founder of this organization? If you know the answer, then do mention it in the comment section below. And if you don't, then do find it out, because it is an important question. And tell me in the comment section below that who is the founder of this India Accelerator. And also remember that this organization signed MOU with Haryana for this startup ecosystem. So now we have our third question. With which company has Gujarat government signed an MOU to set up Gujarat Special Education Region at Dholera Special Investment Region? So again, we have our third MOU in this session only. So guys, the MOUs that are being signed by the states or the central government are really important. Therefore, do not ignore the MOUs that are provided to you in the Spotlight magazine. Now, coming back to our question. So basically, this Gujarat government has signed an MOU with Sarastra Ventures for setting up this Gujarat Special Education Region. Now, what is this region? What is the function? That I will tell you a little later. But first, I want to tell you something about this company. So guys, this is India's largest education infrastructure fund based in Hyderabad. Remember this thing. This is an important fact related to this Sarastra Ventures, that it is the India's largest education infrastructure fund that is based in Hyderabad. Okay. Now, let's discuss the function of this MOU, that is this establishment of Gujarat Special Education Region. So basically, this Dholera Special Investment Region is a region in Gujarat where this Gujarat Special Education Region will be developed. So suppose this is Gujarat, this is Dholera, and this region is going to be this Gujarat Special Education Region. Now, this is basically an illustration to make it more simple for you. Don't take it as the literal thing. It is just an illustration. So now, what is the purpose of this region? The purpose is basically to establish this region as the education cluster. So basically, this is the education cluster. Here you will find university district, you will find schools, you will find innovation district or innovation institutions, you will find discovery institutions. So all these institutions will be located in this education cluster, along with the housing facilities. Now, housing facilities like hostels, so that the students can reside here as well as learn in these institutions. Now, this is just like an education cluster that we have in other parts of the world. In very developed countries, we have such education clusters where the developed education institutions are there, as well as the hostels and the residing facilities are also there. So this is nothing but an innovation towards taking education of India to another level by the Gujarat government. So I hope that this Gujarat Special Education Region or this education cluster is clear to you now, that what is the purpose of this cluster. Now guys, we have discussed a really important MOU. Now I would like to ask you that who is the CM of Gujarat? So do tell me in the comment section below CM and Governor. Fruits, farmer registration and unified beneficiary information system is the portal of which state? So guys, this fruits portal has not been launched recently. Then why is it in the news? There are two major reasons for it being in the news. The first reason is that it has achieved its target. So it's a really good thing that this portal has achieved its target. And second reason is that Canara Bank has become the first bank to get access of this portal. Now, what are these two things? What is the meaning of Canara Bank becoming the first bank to get access to it? So these are some of the things that I will be discussing a little later. But first of all, I want to ask you, I want to tell you the answer of this question. So the answer is Karnataka. Now guys, this Karnataka state government has launched this fruits portal, and under this fruits portal, all the information related to the farmer, like his land records, the crops grown on his land, then the loans taken by that farmer, then insurance taken by that farmer, and the income source, etc. All the information related to a farmer are provided on this fruits portal. Now, what is the purpose of providing all the information related to a farmer on this portal? First purpose is very clear: to provide loans, to make it easier for the farmers to get loans from banks and financial institutions. And through this, banks like Canara Bank can easily get information about the loans taken by an individual farmer and the repayment he has that he has made till now, and his credit score, etc. So such kinds of information will be provided on this platform so that the lending institutions can get it easier to provide loans. So all the loan processing scene will be made easier for the farmers. Now, Canara Bank has become the first bank to get access of this platform. Apart from this, the second benefit that this platform aims to serve is that the land records of the farmers are provided on this platform. So for that, this fruits platform has been integrated with another platform of the state, and that platform is named as Bhumi. So this fruits portal has been integrated with Bhumi. This is again the Karnataka state's platform that digitalized records of land of the farmers. So that's all for this question. I hope that you have got what I'm trying to tell you. And in case you have any kind of doubt related to this portal or related to anything till now that I have discussed till now, then do feel free to ask me. So that's all for this question. Now my question for you is that the Canara Bank chairman, so do tell me in the comment section below that who is the person that is the chairman of Canara Bank. Okay, again, NMOU. So with which company has NMDC Limited, India's largest iron ore producing Navratna company, signed an MOU for joint exploration of iron ore, gold, coal, diamond and other minerals in various states? So guys, it's a really very easy question. An MOU has been signed by NMDC with a company from the options, and the purpose is to jointly explore certain minerals. Now, which company is it? It is option B, Mineral Exploration Corporation Limited. Nothing else is there to be discussed, but my question for you is that who is the chair of this and this? So these are the static facts related to companies that you should keep in your mind, and you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Okay, so this is an important question, guys. Do listen to me very carefully. How much FDI is allowed in DTH sector by Union Cabinet? So DTH is direct to home sector. So direct to home services are the television services that are provided through Dish TV directly. So there are two types of television services, cable networking and DTH. And I hope that you know the difference between these two. And if you don't, then do Google it. It's very easy. Okay. So now, Union Cabinet has allowed 100% FDI into this DTH sector. So the right answer is option A. Guys, do you know that Ministry of Commerce and Industry has allowed this 100% FDI a long back ago? But due to certain information and broadcasting guidelines of Indian government, this was a restriction, or this was not getting off the ground actually. So now the FDI is 100%, and earlier it was 49%. Apart from this, there were other very insignificant changes, I would say, in this direct to home services sector. And what are the changes? First is this FDI value thing, which is very important. Second is related to license. So license period has been increased for DTH companies to 20 years. Licensing fees has been revised from 10% to 8%. So earlier the 10% of gross revenue was charged as the license fees from DTH companies. Now 8% of adjusted gross revenue will be charged from the DTH companies. Apart from this, licensing fees will be paid by these companies on a quarterly basis and not on the yearly basis as they have been doing for quite a long period of time. Apart from this, DTH players have also been allowed to share their infrastructure. Infrastructure as in satellite systems or such kinds of infrastructure that they need to provide the DTH services. Now the purpose is to reduce the consumer's expense as well as to use the scant satellite resources very efficiently. So that is the purpose of this thing, of allowing the infrastructure between the DTH companies. Apart from this, a major announcement has been made by Union Cabinet, that is merging the four media centers or four media companies with one company. So what is this? Let me write this down so that it will become easier for you. So guys, I have written all the four organizations that are being merged with one organization. So Film Division, Directorate of Film Festival, National Film Archives of India, Children's Film Society India, all these four organizations are going to be merged with National Film Development Corporation Limited. Now, why is this being done? This is being done to ensure better governance. So the central government's agenda is more governments, less government. So that in order to keep that in mind, this thing has been done. So remember this thing, that these four organizations have been merged with this organization. Now my question for you is the headquarter or the location of this National Film Development Corporation Limited. Do tell me in the comment section below. And remember all the points that I have told you here. Which bank has launched Infinite India platform for foreign companies? So basically, this Infinite India platform has been launched for foreign companies. Now guys, this is an important platform. Why? That you will get to know 1 minute later. But let's first discuss the answer of this question. So the right answer is ICICI Bank. So this bank has launched this Infinite India portal, which is India's first search portal for foreign companies launched by a bank. So remember this thing, ICICI has become the first bank to launch a portal named as Infinite India for foreign companies in order to ensure ease of doing business for these foreign companies. So value added services or banking services will be provided to foreign companies so that they can come in India and do business. So that is the whole purpose of this portal. But now my question for you is the MD and CEO of ICICI Bank. So that's all for this question, and I hope that you are going to mention your answers in the comment section below. Which company has received the 15th CII ITC Sustainability Award 2020 in Corporate Social Responsibility? So the right answer is NTPC India. Now guys, NTPC has won this award consecutively for the second year. In 2019 as well, this award in the corporate social responsibility category was given to NTPC, and now again in 2020 this award has been given to this company. So remember the category, that is corporate social responsibility. What is Indian men's team rank in the FIH ranking 2020? So this FIH is the International Hockey Federation that governs the sport of hockey, and it has released its ranking very recently. So what is Indian men's ranking? It is fourth. And what is Indian women's ranking? It is ninth. So do remember these rankings. And in this table, I have mentioned top three: men, women, India's rank, and captains. So Belgium is at the top in men's ranking, and Netherlands is at the top in women's ranking. Indian hockey team captain is Manpreet Singh, and women's captain is Rani Rampal. Now, related to Rani Rampal, there is a very interesting fact. So, the fact is that in January 2020 only, she became the first person from the hockey fraternity to win the World Games Athlete of the Year award. So, remember this thing, in January 2020 only she got this award, therefore, it can be asked in the examination. So, that's all for this question. And now we are on the last question of the day. Who is the author of The Light of Asia, the poem that defined the Buddha book? So basically, this book has been written by Jairam Ramesh. So he was one of the union minister, former union minister. Now guys, this book is basically a retelling of another book. So The Light of Asia. Is a poem written by Sir Edwin Arnold in 1879. And this poem basically has been reiterated by Jairam Ramesh or retold by Jairam Ramesh. So that's all for this question. There is nothing much to be discussed here. And now this session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed and learned a lot during the session. And if you have, then do like this video and share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching the video.